I'm a sucker for dynamic fog rolling in for medieval castles. That's where we're going in Horizon Drug.
What's up, soldiers? My name is Greg FPS, and I love making those intros. Hope you guys enjoy them. But today, guys, we're going to be counting down the top 10 pack-a-punch locations in Call of Duty Zombies from Treyarch. Now, you guys were the ones that submitted these maps, and I ordered them accordingly from the number of votes they got. So you might not agree with this list. I personally don't even agree with it because I think Mob of the Dead should be number one, but it ain't. Okay, it ain't. So just deal with it, okay? You guys voted. So anyways, without further ado, let's get right into it. And coming in at the number 10 spot from the map I just made the cinematic for, it is Buried. Now, Buried is actually really, really cool. And as you saw from the cinematic, you literally have to go through a maze in order to get to the pack-a-punch location. Not only that, but you have to make your way through the witch's house, and you're going to get a free perk once you make it all the way through. The only thing that sucks about it is the witches take 2,000 points every single time you get hit. So that is very, very annoying. But I just think that overall, this is a really, really cool place for a pack-a-punch. No one really thought of anything like this before in a Treyarch map, and Buried just had a really cool, unique maze that changed every single time, which I thought was really, really cool and definitely deserved the number 10 spot in this countdown. And coming in at the number 9 spot is going to be 5. Now, honestly, 5 is one of the hardest maps in Call of Duty Zombies. The fact that you have to go from DEFCON 1 through 4 and then eventually be on DEFCON 5 to get the symbol with the pack-a-punch to actually teleport to that room, I think is really, really unique and really cool. Now, the pack-a-punch literally spins out from the wall, which I think is really awesome. And overall, it's just a really cool meeting room in the Pentagon next to the war room, which I think is really, really unique. We've never seen anything really like this before. And overall, this map just has fantastic vibes, and I definitely think it deserves the number 9 spot. Without a doubt, it is one of the coolest and most unique maps in Call of Duty Zombies. And coming in at the number 8 spot, it is going to be Revelations. Now, this is the last map that we got from Treyarch, and they kind of went in with a bang. Basically, what you have to do is turn on all the corruption generators, and then eventually shock a huge apothecan, and then you actually get sucked into the apothecan's stomach, I guess, and you have to shoot out the pack-a-punch by shooting four areas that are actually holding it up, and eventually the pack-a-punch falls. Now, when this map first came out, I vividly remember getting stuck behind the pack-a-punch because I was a complete idiot and stood right under it, like most noobs do, and that was annoying. But anyways, overall, I think this is one of the most unique pack-a-punch areas we've ever been in. There hasn't really been a thing that we need to actually go into, like a living apothecan that we had to go into in order to pack lunch, which I just thought was really, really cool. And overall, it was just really, really unique. So it definitely deserved the number 8 spot. Not my favorite map, not my favorite pack lunch location, but it was definitely pretty stinking cool. And coming in at the number 7 spot is going to be Origins. Now, Origins is a very, very iconic map, probably top 3 for pretty much every single Zombies player ever. And the really cool thing about this map is it was the first time they introduced a brand new look for the mystery box as well as the pack-a-punch machine. Now, the pack-a-punch machine is very, very iconic on this map though, because it takes place right smack in the middle of the freaking map, right on top of the excavation site. You had to turn on all 6 generators, so it did take a little bit of work in order to unlock the Pack-a-Punch machine, but overall, I feel like it's very, very iconic and definitely deserved the number 7 spot, if not higher. Surprisingly, it didn't get voted as much as I would have liked, but still, number 7 is pretty stinking good. And coming in at the number 6 spot, taking place in Morgue City, we got Shadows of Evil. Now, Shadows of Evil is a little bit annoying because you have to do all 4 rituals in order to open up the specific area of the map down below. But overall, this room is really, really cool with the murals on the walls that you can wall run on. I just think it's so cool. The atmosphere of the map is really awesome. And the Pack-a-Punch is so unique. Literally, a tentacle apothecan puts its arm out, grabs your gun, sucks it in, and then releases it with the arm again. I just think it's really, really unique, and I thought this one was really, really cool. So that's why I got the number 6 spot in this week's countdown. And coming in at the number 5 spot is going to be Garad Krovi. Now, this was the first time we actually had dragons moving us or even on the map flying around and blowing fire everywhere. Now, the fact that you were able to harness a freaking dragon and then get dropped off in a historical building that actually was in the Battle of Stalingrad was the coolest thing. Just, it was so awesome. I love the historical significance of this actual Pack-a-Punch area, and just like going way outside the map for this, I just think is so cool. Being able to fly on dragons and then taking the sewer back, I just think it was a really, really cool area. You can also get the dragon strikes as well from that area by holding it off, and overall, I just think that this Pack-a-Punch location was so cool for a map. It was definitely one of the coolest, and that's why I got the number 5 spot. And coming in at the number 4 spot is going to be Shangri-La. Now, a lot of people don't even know how to open up Pack-a-Punch on this map, or for that matter, where it actually is located. You actually have to stand on one of the pressure plates, depending on how many players there are, and eventually it opens up, and you actually go up the stairs that are in the starting room. Now, eventually, you're gonna run out of time, and the water is going to come down the stairs and literally knock you off, which I think is really, really cool, really unique. You kind of feel important when you're all the way up there. You can kind of see the outline of the map, which I think is really, really unique. And I just think it's one of the coolest locations because it, you know, embraces that Shangri-La feel. You feel like you're in the smack middle of the jungle and you can kind of see your surroundings and the outline of the map, which I just think is so, so cool. And this definitely 100% deserved the number 4 spot. Coming in at the number 3 spot is going to be Mob of the Dead. Now, Mob of the Dead, as you guys know, my favorite map. I say this every single top 5, but honestly, Mob of the Dead was so cool. You literally had to build a plane and fly and crash into the Golden Gate Bridge in order to pack a bunch, which I just thought was so freaking unique. This is the first time we ever went so far outside the map to a specific area, and we had to build something in order to get there. It was Jason Plundell's first map, and man, did he hit a home run with this unique, unique design and area for a Pack-a-Punch. I just thought it was so cool to be on the Golden Gate Bridge, and then you have to get electrocuted in the electric chair to go back to the map in afterlife mode. I just thought it was so, so cool, and it definitely 100% deserved the number 3 spot. Coming in at the number 2 spot is a spot that a lot of people actually voted for, and this was Kino Der Toten. Now, Kino, you just use that teleporter that's right on the stage, and you go up top to the actual projector room, which is really cool. Once you pack a bunch in there, you can look down and see all of the zombies and the Nova crawlers that are all around the stage, and you can throw grenades. I know a lot of people do that. They throw grenades, they buy more grenades off the wall for 250 points, and they keep chucking grenades, and then eventually you actually get teleported into a room where you can actually get a film reel and then put the film reel in the actual projector the next time you go in, and it shows a different thing on the screen, which I thought was really, really unique, really cool. Kino is such one of those, you know, nostalgic maps, and I just thought that this 100% deserved to be number two, 100%. All right, the time has come for the honorable mentions. There's going to be two this week, and the first one is going to be Ascension. Now, literally, you have to use all of the moon landers in order to open up the rocket. Then you can launch the rocket, and you, if you have a ray gun, you can shoot it twice, and it will blow up, and you get a free double points once you go underneath the launch site, and that is actually where you can pack a punch. Really, really cool location. I thought this was going to get voted more, but it actually didn't get voted at all, but I definitely think it deserved an honorable mention. And the second one is going to be Transit. Although it is not many people's favorite map, Transit was very unique. You actually had to go down to the bank area, and you had to drop down, and you actually had to build the actual pack-a-punch machine itself. Now, you had to get the three different parts around that area and build it, which I thought was really cool, and it was definitely really, really unique. It was something that we've never seen before, and I thought it was pretty just different and cool. And coming in at the number one spot, one of the most requested things I've ever gotten for a top 10, it's gonna be Moon. I mean, it got last week's best first room and this week's best pack-a-punch location. The pack-a-punch is literally in no man's land in the starting room. Now, the coolest thing about this is you literally spawn in facing the freaking pack-a-punch machine, but unfortunately you can't really pack-a-punch. But the cool thing is you can actually use the hacker, which is the little device that's on Moon, and you can hack the pack-a-punch area, and it actually drops down the cage around the entire area for a limited amount of time, where the zombies actually can't go in the cage and hit you, which I thought was really, really unique. This was something that we'd never seen before, and just a great way to end off Black Ops 1 and the nostalgia for that game in general. I thought this was a really, really cool choice. A lot of you guys voted for it, and I agree that Moon definitely deserves the best pack-a-punch location in Call of Duty Zombies. So anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this week's top 10. These videos take a lot of time to record all the different clips. I'm sure you guys have seen some of those clips in previous videos that I have made, just because I am not able to literally spend a literal day, 24 hours, to record all of these freaking pack-a-punch areas. I did half of them, I recorded them, and it took me about 8 hours just to actually get the footage, because sometimes on like 5, for example, you can go down and get pissed off, and then I need to take like a half hour break and just drink some apple juice before I get back to it. So that is why I had to reuse some clips. But I really hope you guys did enjoy. I've been spending a lot more time on all these videos that I'm making, and I really feel like it's rewarding to get the effects of this, because each time I feel like I'm making a really just overall good video that takes a lot of time and a lot of editing, and I really do enjoy that. I get a lot more fulfillment than making just quick videos that are pretty much what everyone else makes. So I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, be sure to drop it a like. Subscribe if you guys are new to my channel. I'm going to be doing this series every single week, and honestly, I'm just so hyped for the direction my channel is going with the daily streams and everything like that. So my name is Greg FPS. I'll see you guys later. Have an amazing day, and peace.